warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So today I'll be working, cutting an Egyptian hijab for a baby girl, a 3-year-old girl, Egyptian hijab. So first of the measure, the material I'll be using is a thick lycra fabric of 2 trousers or 1.5. So but 2 trousers at most. So I divided my fabric into two so as to make it easy for cutting. So the materials I'll be needing is my French cuff and my scissors, my office pin most likely, my tape measure, my chalk and my long ruler. So the measurement I'll be working with are the face circumference, the length, the front length of the khimar, the back length, and then the round sleeve of the khimar. So the face circumference I'll be working with is 18 inches. So what I 18 inches, the front measurement is 42 inches and the back measurement is 49 inches. So what I'll be doing first, after folding my fabric, this one, I folded it into two. The next thing to do is to divide my face circumference into four. The face circumference I'm working with is 18. 18 divided by 2, that is 9. And 9 divided by 2, that is 4.5. So, because I'm working with a stretchy fabric, I'm not going to add any sewing allowance to the face circumference. So, I'll start my measurement for this part of the fabric. This is the closed part, the open part that I folded into. So I'll chalk out my 4.5 inches. 4.5 inches. This is my 4.5 inches. Then from this part, I'll come down by 15 inches because I'm cutting it for a female girl. So 15 inches. This is my 15 inches. So I'll make use of my long ruler. Then from the part I chalked out my face circumference to this part, I'll use my chalk to connect the lines. So I've connected the line. Next thing to do is to chalk out the length, the full length of my front length, the front length of my khimar. So the front length of the khimar is 42 inches. I'll go on to chalk that out. From this part of the fabric, I'll come down. This is my 42 inches. But for the M allowance, I'll add 1 inch for the M allowance. So this is 43 inches. 43 inches. Next thing to do is to find the connect my lines. 43 inches. I'll chop out the 43 inches from this part to give me a straight line. 43 inches. So I'll use my long ruler to connect my line. 43 on this part and the 43 from this part. I'll use my long ruler to connect the two lines. So after connecting the line, the next thing to do now is to come to this side. This is the shoulder slant from the round face circumference. So I'll come in by 3.5 from the edge of the fabric to this side, then I'll puff out my 3.5 towards this side. Then after measuring, before doing that, I'll measure 4 inches for the sleeve opening. 4 inches. So because I'm using an elastic to hold it together, so it will become smaller after sewing. So 4 inches, and I'll cuff my line towards the 4 inches, 3.5 line. Then from the end of the fabric, I'll use my straight ruler to connect that to 3.5. I'll make sure my line is straight enough. So I've connected that to. Next thing to do is to find the midpoint from this line, from this point to this edge of the fabric. I'll find the midpoint. The total inches is 17 inches. So 17 divided by 2, that is 8.5. So from this part, I will mark out my 8.5 on this cloth. So this is my 8.5. So the next thing to do is to make use of my French curve. So from this edge, I'll connect it to the 8.5 to make a slice curve, so that it will give the edge of my jab a sharp edge. That's the reason for doing this curve. So that is that on the front part of the jab. I'll cut it out and show you the next step, the next process. So after this is the cutout, I've cut out my front part of my hijab. So the next thing to do now is to cut out the back part. So I'll lay my fabric down and I'll show you the next thing to do. So after laying the other part of my fabric down, the next thing to do now is to place the front part that I cut out on the other fabric. I'll place it on it to cut that out too. I'll make sure that my fabric is well aligned. So I'll place it. So after laying the front part that I cut on the back part, this is the new fabric I laid down. This is the front part that I already cut. So after laying it on each other, after placing the front fabric on, the next thing to do now is to mark out the length of the back length of the khimar, if I have. And if I don't have, the thing I'll just do is to add probably 8 from 7, 8 or 10 inches to the back length, to the front length. So that's what I used to call the back length out. But if I have the length, the measurement for the back length, there's no need to do that. So the measurement for my back length is 49. So now I cut out 42 inches for this one, plus the same allowance for 3 inches. What I'll just do is that my 49 inches, I'll just add 7 inches plus sewing allowance, that's 8 inches, 1 inch sewing allowance. Or better still, I can come up here and measure my 49 inches plus 1 inch sewing allowance, that is 50 inches. So I've chugged out my 15 inches. The next thing to do is to connect this point to this point. Because the two edges, the side edge must meet. One must not exceed the other. So I'll use my free hand to connect that point to the side here. So after doing that, I'll just take my scissors and cut it out like that, and I'll show you the next step. So after placing my front measurement or the back measurement on the other fabric, I've cut out my back part of my khimar. This is the back part and this is the front part. You see, the back is longer than the front. So next thing to do now is to cut the sleeve. So for the sleeve, the measurement I'm using is from the center front to the sleeve. The measurement I need is 25. So from the center front to what I cut out here is 20 inches. That means I'll be needing more 5 inches to be connected to this part. So the next thing to do now is to take the fabric and I'll fold it like this. This is non-folding, so I'll fold this like this and I'll make sure the folding is up to 5 inches. This is 5 inches plus half inch sewing allowance, so that's 5.5. So this is what I'll cut out for my round. I'll fold it into so that it will give me for the two sleeves. So then the round sleeve that I'm working with, I said 4 inches. I used 4 inches here. So what I'll just do is to measure this part 4.5 inches and use it to cut this piece out. 4.5 inches plus 1/2 inch of my allowance, that's 5 inches. So I'll chop out my 5 inches. That's what I'm going to cut out. So that is the sleeve part. I'll connect it to my fabric like this. That will give it. So the next thing to do now is to cut the cap of my hijab. So I'll look for a piece of fabric that is big enough to cut the cap. This is okay. What I need is the face circumference is 18. So I'll fold it into two like this. Then I'll fold this into two. Okay. So what I'm cutting out is the measurement I'm needing now is 3.5 inches on this part, 3 inches. Plus 1/2 inch sewing allowance, 3.5 inches. And on this part, I'll chalk out 7.5 inches. Connect the lines. So this is the cap I will be using. So I'll ensure that the center is touching each other like this. And I will notch it. After notching this, I will notch the center of this is the front part of my box. The cap is to be connected to the back part of yeah, so I'll notch the center of the back part too. Then I'll use my pin to connect it, to connect the cap to the center of the hijab. I'll make sure the front part of this cap is facing the front part. This is the front part of the fabric, this is the back. So I'll ensure that it's facing each other. So the next thing to do now is to open up my hijab. This is the opening. This is how it's going to look. This is this. And I'll place the front part of the fabric. I'll make sure it's facing the front part. So I'll place it on each other like this. And I will take it to my machine to join. I will join all these parts. I'll close it. I'll leave this part open. I'll close this part to all the way down. I'll close it. I'll do that for the other side. And I'll connect this cap to the hijab. Then I'll come back to show you the final outcome of the hijab. My hijab. I already joined the sides here and down to the last edge. Then I joined the sleeve, the cutout sleeve. I joined my cap. I used 1/2 inch to for all my joinings. And after joining all the sides and the sleeve and the cap to the hijab, the next thing to do is to come down and hem your edges. So I've done that. And now the next thing to do is to go and press my hijab, and then I'll show you the final outfit.